Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Connor. I'm here with my father,
Kevin.
And today we are back almost at the end of our Kanye West journey. We have two more studio albums left. This is the short one that we are doing, which is titled Jesus is King. It's from 2019, and it is a gospel-type album.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not really going to tell you much about it because I just want to see your raw reaction. I don't want to say, oh, it's a masterpiece, and then you're let down, or I tell you, oh, it's dog shit, and then you go, you know, go into the record with that in mind. So I'm just going to play it, and I'll let you make your own judgments on the quality and what you like or dislike.
Okay. Stuff. No, so. I'm into it. It seems like it's been so long since we did Yay, right?
Track number one is titled Every Hour.
Is this sped up?
No.
Oh. God, the tempo on this thing's crazy.
It's a weird tempo, right?
Yeah.
This is the Sunday service choir.
Oh, wow.
So that's just the intro.
Oh, okay. That was good. It was fucking chaotic.
It was very chaotic for like a religious intro to an album.
I thought it was started at, I think, 45. It sounded like
they sped up or something. Yeah.
Like super fast, right? But amazing vocals. I think it was just the tempo was so far, you didn't really grasp the greatness of it.
Mm-hmm, I agree.
I think it was a little bit slower. You would get the...
Okay, we'll go on to track number two.
God is king, we the soldiers. Ultra beam out the solar. When I get to heaven's gate, I ain't gotta peek over. Keeping perfect composure when I scream at the chauffeur. John 8:33, we the descendants of Abraham. Yea, should be made free.
Cool.
John 8:36, to whom the Son set free is free indeed.
I have to say, it's really nice to hear Connie after a month.
Yeah, it's been a little while, right?
Yeah, to shit, there's a lot of hallelujahs, right?
Yeah.
Wake up with Judas kissing makeup, even with the bitter cup, forgave my brothers a drink up.
It was nice hearing Kanye again, and the chorus, the choir is absolutely fantastic, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I think that's about it. I feel for this song, to be honest.
Yeah, no, it's...
It doesn't...
Doesn't do too much, right? I like the drums a lot. The... Doom.
Doom, doom. Yeah, yeah. The power of the drums, but it's just... I don't know. It just didn't... I didn't feel... It's weird when you don't feel anything.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't feel anything. And I'm not a religious person, so it's for the lyrics. I'm like, God is king. We are the... We're soldiers. I understand it all, but I just... I don't get any...
Emotional attachment.
Yeah,
to it.
Yeah.
We'll go to track number three, which is titled Follow God.
Okay.
The ashtray. Stretch my hands to you.
Life like this is what your life like. Try to live the life right. People really know you push your buttons like type right. Yeah, supernova for a night like dreaming at my dad, and he told me it ain't Christ like. But nobody never tell you when you're being like Christ. Only ever seeing me, only when they need. Like if Tyler Perry made a movie for BT, I've been looking for a new way. I'm just really trying not to really do
it. It's nice to hear a sample though, eh?
Yeah.
My best though. Lock up on a text though. Nothing else next though. Not another word, let a picture or a decimal. Wrestling with God, I don't really want to rest. So is it on me? I start spazzing back. He said, they ain't Christ like. I said, ah!
I gotta agree with you that the flow on this and the rhymes,
yeah,
the way it is, it was the high point for me, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it's nice to hear a sample because I thought it was gonna be all
just like choirs,
all and choirs and hallelujahs. So that sort of was pretty cool that it changed up and it wasn't that, you know,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because I'm just picturing the oh hallelujah, you know, that whole thing the whole time, right?
Yeah. No, that one's one track that I don't mind too much just because
yeah,
it's less religious themed and he's talking about his dad more. I can connect with it in a way. Not that you told me that I was acting not Christ-like, but just that father.
There was a time yeah. when you were younger.
When I was a child.
Yeah.
No, but just that, you know, communicating with your father aspect mm-hmm. of the track is something that at least I can pull out of it.
Yeah, yeah.
Anyway, we'll keep going. Track number four. This is an interesting one. It's titled Closed on Sunday.
And I'll tell you, I can relate to this because you didn't have to live in the day, but I did.
When everything was closed on Sunday?
Liquor stores were closed on Sunday.
Oh, God.
And you could not, you'd have to plan the night before.
Because, wait, why were you drinking on a Sunday, though? You usually drink on a Saturday.
Well, Sunday mornings when you hangover. You got to crack another, the old hair of the dog. Oh, this is nice. Oh, I'm already peaceful, man.
Close on Sunday. You my Chick-fil-A. Close on Sunday. You my Chick-fil-A. Hold the selfies. Put the gram away.
Talks about Instagram a lot, eh?
Get your family.
Yeah.
Y'all hold hands and pray. You're my number one. With the lemonade. Raise our sons.
I got a question to ask, okay? After.
Train them in the faith. Through temptations. Stand up for my home.
One of my favorite tracks so far.
Mm.
I really.
Even yeah. if I take this walk alone.
Right on.
Bow down to the king upon the throne. My home.
This is Kanye singing, right?
Yeah.
Jesus, his voice got.
He's better.
Jesus. His voice got way better, right? Mm.
We'll think twice stepping onto my land. Even stand a chance. Chick-fil-A?
Okay, the question I gotta ask you, because as soon as I read the lyric, is Chick-fil-A a place in the States?
It's a restaurant.
Oh, it's a restaurant.
But they're closed on every Sunday.
Oh. That's, okay. I didn't know if he was saying Chick-fil-A, like chicken filet. Like,
no,
like
no, it's a restaurant, okay. And they're notoriously known for being closed Sundays. Like, there's memes. I've seen one on Twitter of a guy who's like, oh man, my girlfriend's, I can't hang, I miss my girlfriend so much, but she's working all day today at Chick-fil-A, and he'll post it on a Sunday, and everyone's like, yeah man, you're getting cheated on.
So is that a religious reason?
I don't know, actually. Oh. We don't have them here, so I have no idea. Oh, okay. But that track was one that stood out to me right away, like with the guitar, I loved it, and it was, and then the choir, and it's very peaceful.
Yeah.
The Chick-fil-A line was one that I absolutely hated when I first listened to it, because I'm like, you just ruined the song. It was like, you know, it's really, it was, it's know, really it, cool,
perfect.
Guitar, peaceful, and then you my Chick-fil-A number one with the lemonade. It's like, I don't, but it's come to the point where it's like, now it's like funny.
Yeah,
you know, it's kind of like the bleached asshole line where it's like, the first time I heard it, I was like, you just ruined a beautiful song.
Yeah, yeah.
But then now it's like notoriously known as
for that,
like something
yeah.
funny. And it's like, so I don't mind this track anymore.
I love the synths coming in here too. Like this is hands down my favorite. And it wasn't, it wasn't super religious.
No, not at all. Yeah.
Yeah. So it had some fun in there and it was a good track. It was, but like I agree with you. It's like, it had, it opened, and the guitars and the sounds and the strength, that was super, super peaceful, right?
If he released this as an instrumental, like you know, separately, I'd listen to that.
Oh, for sure.
Cool. It's a really cool instrumental. Track number 5 is titled On God.
How you get so much favor on your side? Accept them as your Lord and Savior, I replied. That's your love, that neighbor, not the bad. I'm a rat. That's on God. The mimic gotta end it, that's on me. He the new commander and the chief. That's on Keith. That's on Cobb. Before the ranch, I had horses in the garage. When I thought the book of Job was a job. The devil had my soul, I can't lie. Life gon' have some lows and some highs. Before the Grammys ever gave a nod. L.A. Reid, that's on Clive. That's no jive. That's on Cobb. Off the 350s, he supplied. The IRS want they 50 plus I tied.
Hey, I like that track.
Yeah, no, it's a cool one.
I like that track. It was super, super easy to follow.
Straightforward.
And he's saying it's on God, these things that happen. I like his reference. I like him talking about L.A. Reid and Clive Davis in there. Mm-hmm. The greatest artist resting or alive. That was a fun track. That was
cool,
good.
Cool synths going on, too.
Really cool. I was thinking, is that...
Synths and the heavy bass.
Yeah, I was thinking if that's, you know, who with the Mike Dean.
I don't know if it was Mike Dean. I know Pierre Bourne helped produce this track, so maybe it's Mike, but I'm not sure.
Oh, Pierre Bourne, that's who. Okay.
Yeah, he's a producer, but yeah, no, not bad track. Another one that's, you know, relatively good on this record.
It is. I'm glad it's unfolding this way right now, because I really did think it was all choir, gospel. Yeah, I didn't think there'd be synths or anything cool like that. I thought it'd just be. All like it would drive me a little bit batty just being all complete gospel,
like,
right?
That intro,
like the thing. Intro thing, I thought it was that, the hallelujah, and I'm like, oh man, this is gonna be a really difficult listen.
Yeah, no, it changes up.
Oh, it is changing. Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
Track number 6, it's titled Everything We Need.
Beautiful.
Nice tie, Dolla.
Wow, beautiful.
Switch your attitude.
We like those things, eh?
Yeah, the little things.
We have everything we need.
That is so hot.
Ty Dolla Sign always has amazing vocal performances. Oh,
that's beautiful, man. This is Ty here, or Aunt Clemons?
Oh, this is Aunt Clemons.
Oh. Those vocals are the bomb, man.
Yeah, no, Ty Dolla Sign just always, I can think off the top of my head, every song that he's on, Free Part 2.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Is he just a singer?
He's a singer. I haven't listened to his solo work, so I don't know if he does rapping, but I've heard him on, he's on Real Friends, like for Kanye stuff. He's on Real Friends. He's on Free Part 2.
It gives me a real back to old school Boys to Men, mm-hmm. that really four-part harmony.
Huge harmony.
But it was really, like, that was... I could listen to a whole song of whatever they were doing there just like that. That the way it was, and then you heard a synth in the background. But that, when I say ear appealing, that's really ear appealing.
Mm-hmm.
You want to suck it in through your ears.
What was the album we just did recently that had Ty Dolla Sign on it? Oh, Call Me If You Get Lost. He was on What's Your Name. That's what I remember.
Oh, the one we did, the beach. Yeah.
Yeah, the beach.
Yeah, okay.
Trek 7. Water featuring Aunt Clemons.
God, I love these harmonies, man.
Jesus, flow through us. Jesus, heal the bruises. Jesus, clean the music. Jesus, please use us. Anything.
You hear how that synth follows his...
Yeah. Matches his pattern.
Your pattern, yeah. That was cool. The highlight for me was the Aunt Clemons, I think it is.
Yeah, I'm not crazy over that track.
Yeah, the highlight for just like for sure with just him, like the when they come to it's water, we are water, we are water.
I like that part.
Like a newborn daughter.
Yeah,
that's a really cool phrasing, right?
Yeah, that part's neat, but yeah, I'm not crazy for that track, but it is cool how it's not like it's a gospel album, but you know. That doesn't sound like a gospel song, really.
No. It sounded a little more dirty.
Yeah, like a porno song.
I was going to say, but I didn't want to put this whole thing in there, but it sounded like some of the pornos I watched.
Yeah. Track 8, it's titled God Is.
Wow.
That's Kanye.
Is it? Wow. Yes. What?
He's working on his vocals.
Holy shit.
Everything that I bear, praise the Lord. Worship Christ with the best of your portions. I know I won't forget all he's done. All are welcome through the door. You won't ever be the same when you call on Jesus' name. Listen to the words I'm saying. Jesus saved me, now I'm sailing. I know.
Listen to his voice going there, eh?
Yeah.
Those are some real flat old school tones. Well, I didn't think I would like that song at the beginning. And I'll tell you, this is what I feel. At the beginning, it was like I was going along with, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then the first verse was had me going. I'm like, okay, it's just... It's not usually Kanye's way to force a thing, but when he was forcing faithfulness and miraculous together,
yeah.
It was just like, okay, man, you're just going blah, blah, blah. But when he hit this ain't about dead religion, just about a revolution, all the captives were forgiven. Then he got into that, and his voice started to change, and you heard him losing his voice.
Yeah, it had that raspy
kind of voice, like, yeah. This is my kids, this is my crib, this is my wife, this is my life, this is a God-given right. Thank you, Jesus won the fight. All that from that beginning about the dead religion and the revolution,
mm-hmm.
really cool.
Yeah.
Really,
yeah.
really cool. It picked up there. I wish it had that same flow throughout the whole thing. It would have been fantastic.
Yeah, that's the thing with this album for me is like every song kind of has pieces that I like,
mm-hmm.
but there's not like a song that I'm like front to back, oh, that's amazing.
Yeah,
like
I feel
it's,
that.
It's right. Like everything is, oh, this part's cool. I wish he, you know, fleshed that out into better idea, you know, took that idea and made it better. Or I wish he did this and then took out that part. Or, mm-hmm. you know, it's...
Yeah, I love the power. Like you just hit it right here. I love the power of that when it came on, when it kicked up, right? Giving me a revelation. That whole thing there just got me really, really excited. Not, at the beginning, I'm like, oh my God, this is the King of Kings, Lords of Lords. He's in the bunch of the stores. And I was like,
yeah.
I was just like, whatever. But then he just, it was, and you know, again, it was like the passion here. Maybe if the passion that you could feel that grit
mm-hmm.
at the beginning, maybe it would have made those, you know, the faithfulness and the miraculous a little bit better, right?
Track number 9, Hands On.
Hands on, wonder if they're gonna read your rights. 13th Amendment, 3 strikes. Made a left when I should have made a right. Told God last time on life. And a hypocrite. Change, he ain't really different. He ain't even try to get permission. Ask for advice and they dissed him. Try to lead you to Jesus. We get called halfway believers.
Those background things only are crazy.
Really cool.
Read Ephesians. Only if they knew what I knew. If that's all the love you have, that's all you get. To say I'll change, you think I'm joking. To praise his name, you ask what I'm smoking. Yes, I understand your religion.
That was the that background thing was wow, it's I don't even know what it was. I thought it was vocoder or what.
It's the first ever experimental gospel song.
Yeah. I want to go back to the verse that you were saying there because it's...
I just like that verse because I... Correct me in the comments if I'm wrong, but from my understanding, it's... I remember Kanye was getting backlash when he said he was doing a gospel album, but he was getting backlash not from his fans, but from actual Christians.
Like, oh, really? Oh,
yeah, like we don't want Kanye doing a gospel album. Like it's Kanye West.
Yeah, yeah.
We don't want him. So it's kind of, from my understanding, it's him talking about that, addressing, you know, what, you know, he wants to do this album and he's getting judged by people.
Oh, okay, 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 okay. What's it? What have you been hearing from the Christians? They'll be the first ones to judge me. I feel like every time I'm not going to recite the lyrics anymore. Because last time I did it, I sounded whack. Remember?
Yeah, yeah, you sound like you're having a stroke. But no, I like that verse on that song for sure. And it's not one I go back and listen to almost ever, but it's, you know, it's got some cool sounds to it, cool instrumentation.
Yeah, no, it's cool, but it's like, I don't think I'd ever, for me to go back to it and listen to it again, right?
Track number 10 is titled Use This Gospel.
I love the use of the synth bass underneath mm-hmm. to make those vocals fat, eh?
Yeah.
Use this gospel for protection.
How could he not be the greatest? In my bed undercovers when undercovers had raided. My presence is happy, belated. Fashionably late, I'm just glad that you made it. A lot of damaged souls, I done damaged those. And in my arrogance, took a camera pose. Caught with a trunk, a Barry man of Lowe's. They sing a different tune when the slammer close.
Oh my God, this is 1980 all over again. People knock Kenny G for the corniness, right? Mm,
but no, it's great.
He's fantastic, man. That was cool.
Yeah, that's one of my favorites off the record.
I really, really like that one, man. I really love his the chorus.
Mm-hmm.
He says, gospel for protection, the hard road to heaven.
Yeah, it's got a nice melody, especially yeah. following the you know, vocoded vocals of the
yeah.
And then the
I don't know if I would have put the thing in there that much. I would have taken out a little bit more.
The
door thing.
Ding, ding, ding.
Yeah, I was fucking twitching out, man.
Track 11, Jesus is Lord.
Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord.
Fucking horns are killer.
Mm. It's a very horny record.
Jesus is Lord.
That was fat, man. I you know what, I'll tell you, I love orchestration and horns. Real, you know, the real
I love orchestration when it meets, you know, crosses with hip hop.
Oh,
it's one of my favorite.
Yeah, and then if you've got that orchestra, and then if a beat came in there, it's like, and you have it. Oh man,
I think that's why I like Late Registration so much, because yeah. it's got the orchestration and then the hip hop element, which is just fantastic. But yeah, that's the album. It's very short, and it's.
I'm glad we listened to it though, like you said.
Yeah, it's a mixed bag. There's some good elements, there's some not so great elements. Mm-hmm. It's not a record I come back to at all, but it's part of Kanye's discography, and there's definitely elements of this that kind of, like, I feel like the good elements of this kind of got sprinkled into Donda.
Oh yeah.
So it does feel like it was a stepping stone from Ye to Donda.
Okay.
So it's like you had Ye, and then this was like a little bridge.
Well, every album has done that through this.
Mm-hmm, for sure.
Right? Through this, you've shown something, you know, like for me, when we jump, it's crazy. I go back to one of the albums, which I thought everyone's going to be, oh my God, this is making whacked or whatever. I love Yeezus.
Yeah, yeah.
I love the power in it. I love the everything that happened about it, man. It was just like, it's such a cool album. And I thought, oh my God, this is so different, right? Well,
and Yeezus, you wouldn't have Yeezus if it wasn't for 808s and Dark Twisted Fantasy. Because
yeah.
those, the elements of the grandness of Dark Twisted and the auto-tune of 808s kind of combined with this heavier industrial sound to make Yeezus. So
that's crazy how you see it. I'm so glad we did it this way, right?
Yeah, from College Dropout
all the way up, yeah.
Instead of just going random.
Randomly, order. Yeah, because it's really neat to do that, right? And
anything you want to say before we close off?
No, I do. I just want to say that, like I said in many other videos, that it's a crazy time right now and things are going a little bit nutty, and just love each other and be kind to each other. When you see somebody, say hi, wave to them. Don't look at your phone. Just give them a wave, say hi, you know.
Goes a long way.
It goes huge, man. It goes huge. You know, you
could
and I
change somebody's whole mood.
Connor and I went out for coffee the other day, and he went in to get the drinks, and a fellow a couple seats away from me was sitting there, and I had the dog with me. Connor was inside, and he just reached out and said, "Hey, how you doing?" And we ended up having this really cool conversation for 10 minutes and talking, and while Connor was in the store. And it was just one of those interactions that I've been missing so much during COVID, and also with the advent of telephones that you carry around where you hide, and you go into this and you forget there's somebody right next to you, right? So, you know, talking is huge, man, and it's a good thing to do. So,
all right. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you soon with some more album reactions. So stay safe, everybody. Love you.
Bye-bye.
Peace.